it's great to be nominated and amongst like really amazing, incredible directors. So yeah, I'm thrilled. So.
We were thrilled to watch the film Ukraine Is Not a Brothel. It's a fascinating subject. Kitty, if you can just start by telling us a little bit about what inspired you to delve into this world and to bring these wonderful women's story to life.
Well, my grandmother's Ukrainian, so I was traveling around Ukraine and I caught a glimpse of them protesting and I thought it was fabulous, so I tracked them down and started shooting their protests and stayed for 14 months and kind of became part of the group in a lot of ways and followed them around the world.
Of course, I mean, it's a type of protest that I think attracts a lot of attention, both positive and negative. What was your experience during that time working with the movement and sort of seeing the inner workings, I guess, of the very flashy protests that we do see?
They're amazing girls, they're strong girls. There were some things I disagreed with in the way the movement was run, but most things, I mean, I really believe in the women and I think they've got the power to move forward and do whatever they want to do. They're going to take over the world, I'm afraid. Yeah, that's it.
I guess the obvious question, what's the reaction been from audiences, particularly here in London and around the world when you have been screening the film?
The reaction, and like yesterday after the film, it was good to see women who came to us and said like, let me shake your hand, because it was really great film, it was a really great story. So and we see that like, tomorrow we will meet some activists here in UK who want to start famine here. So especially also this festival gave us the possibility to start famine in the UK.
For people who perhaps aren't familiar with the organization and its goals, can you tell us a little bit about what it is that you want to achieve and how you're hoping to do that?
We want to destroy patriarchy and free its manifestations. The first one is sex industry, the second one is religion, and the third one is dictatorship.
What is your strategy for doing that? How do you feel you're going to achieve those ends?
Our strategy is sextremism, sex attacks. We are attacking patriarchy to provoke society to show this ugly face, to take off the mask from the society and to show that what is the real ideas, what is the real ideology exists now against women.
I guess the obvious question, those types of protests, whilst grabbing attention to the work of the cause, for some people, also raises questions of, is the best way to necessarily attack a patriarchal, sexist society to expose yourself publicly naked? I mean, obviously this is something that people criticize. Can you maybe respond to that?
We made sexism as our weapon. We transformed our body into our weapon. We take back the control under our body into our hands. This is how it's working. And it's really working, because maybe here it's too calm country, maybe like you cannot see it, but in Russia, in Ukraine, in Belarus, in Tunisia, we stay in jail, we are arrested, we are followed by a secret service, we are attacked physically, too many things we face because they completely understand that this is a great threat for patriarchy, for dictatorship.
What was it about Kitty that gave you the confidence that she was the right person to help tell that story and to put it on screen like this?
At first, she's a feminist, and when we met her, and when we saw that she makes good videos for us just for action, we understood that she's a great professional, and she's a woman, she's feminist, she understands us, she can understand our fears, she can understand our some thoughts, that she can understand us like more than the other filmmakers who makes films about us. So that's why like she's the right person. Yeah.
What was your reaction when you first saw the finished film? What was your reaction to that first screening?
We first saw it, we have seen it just 2 days before presentation in Venice, and we were, of course, it was like during the edition, we didn't have any rights to change something or to say, Kitty, don't cut this or put this in the film. So for us, we have seen only final version, and we were like, okay, that's the time to say to open up with the truth, with the naked truth of our group. So like we were nervous, but in the same time, we were happy that finally we will say this this truth to the public.
Talking to the public, I mean, you mentioned plans to open a branch of the organisation here in the UK. If people would like to get involved with your cause, where can they go for more information? Apart from watching this film, where can they find out more about what you're trying to achieve?
Just go to our pages on Facebook, Famine International, Famine France, Famine Holland, Famine Poland, Famine UK, and write their messages there, or write to my personal Facebook page, and we will answer and we will start to talk and can, like, start to teach them how to become sextremist.
Lee, my final question for you. What are you hoping audiences are going to take away from this film, and do you know what you're moving on to next yet?
Wow, I don't know. I really always hope that young women can learn from this film and this story and see kind of these women rising up against these sort of patriarchal forces in their own lives. And hopefully it can inspire young girls to do the same if they're under similar circumstances. And yeah, I want to keep making films about women's rights around the world as much as I can. But yeah, it's a bit secret for now. Yeah, thanks.